faith cometh by hearing, and it's released by speaking. For the word of God is quick, powerful, creative, constructive, and life-changing. The word of God you're about to hear is from the staple of God's Will Media Network. Get ready for a life-changing encounter with God's word.
Your preservation is highly, seriously connected with your association. Amen. I told us yesterday that most of the problems that you see people get into are product of association, uninvestigated relationships. Every relationship is spiritual. Every relationship you find yourself in is a spiritual one. And that is why from time to time, you must vet those relationships. I said one day I was reading the scripture. I read the account of King Asa. If you have ever read the account of King Asa, King Asa was a very correct king that served the Lord in his days. He was the one that introduced to the nation of Israel the teaching priest. You know, there are some, he said, when there was no teaching priest, this man led the entire Israel to swear that they will serve the Lord their God all the days of their life, which they did. They did swear to God that they are going to serve him. And I begin to read miraculous manifestation of how he brought revival to the nation of Israel. But all of a sudden, King Asa died prematurely. Then I began to think that why would God allow somebody that worked for him tremendously to this extent? Then he now died prematurely. Where did he miss it? In fact, I began to query the integrity of God after reading that place, that why would God let this man, that it is the same scripture that told us how righteous he was, how much he did for God, how he brought the people's mind to their God. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? There is no time for me to go through that scriptures, but you can read it when you get home. Yeah, I think it's in the Second Kings. You know, it was the son of Jehoshaphat. That was the king that reigned, the second king that reigned after Jehoshaphat's rule. Now, I read carefully. Then I discovered one thing. Do you know what I discovered? I saw strange marriage. The Bible recorded that he married one of the daughters of Pharaoh that is used to idol worship. Some of us don't know how important marriage is. That was, and the Holy Spirit told me that. Did you see? This is where the devil came in. He said, not only him, he said, Solomon, his father, did the same. The Bible said that, and those, you know, Solomon became very rich. It was not that he married 700 wives and 300 concubines. That was the problem. If he had married 700 wives in Israel and 300 concubines in Israel, he wouldn't have had any problem. Where he got his problem from was the strange women that he married from Egypt. They were the one that brought idol worship back to the nation of Israel through him. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? As wise as he was, association turned the wisest man on earth to a fool. He was so full of wisdom. The Bible recorded that there has not been anybody that manifested the audacity of the wisdom of Solomon. Each time people encounter him, they marvel and they wonder what kind of human being is this. But the association destroyed all his legacies. He brought in strange men. And the Bible said that his wife turned his heart away from the Lord his God. And this was a man that the Bible recorded loved God with all his heart. But the association drifted his heart away from God. Each time we warn people about who they associate with, they take it lightly. It's not something that you should joke with. I don't joke with the association. I see an unbeliever as a potential Satan. Because when somebody is an unbeliever, they can do anything. An unbeliever is primarily a very carnal person. They can become a witch in just a short while. They can easily forget the good you have done for them in just a short while. They are driven by the flesh. They can put you into trouble within a short while. So I'm telling you the scripture now. Look at great men. These strange women turned the heart of King Solomon against God and finished all his legacies, destroyed everything about him, finished his wealth. It may interest you to know that his son could not inherit his wealth. Is that bad? Read the Bible. His legacies were destroyed. The kingdom was divided under Solomon. He was the one who received that prophecy. How many of you know that? Huh? So, association is dangerous. I told you that Samson wouldn't have died the way he died if he didn't have taste for strange women. It was strange women that he had taste for that led to his disaster. Because there is no way the Philistines would have gotten him through any woman that is from Israel. They won't hand over Samson to the Philistines. But the Bible recorded that the father used to tell him that, why do you go to the Philistines to choose wife? Are there not fine ladies among us here? He would say that, I like her, get her for me. That was his response. So he died in the lap of a strange woman. Isn't it not funny? Somebody is asking you the secret of your power and you told her a lie, and before you know what is happening, she brought people to come and pick you up. She did it the first time, the second time. You're not supposed to run away. But when you ask taste for strange things, it will affect your sense of reasoning. Lust destroys what we call common sense. You will see somebody that is driven by lust. They are always void of common sense. That is why you see a man who is over 60 running after an 18 years old who is supposed to see like a granddaughter. But lust will make him see her in a different way. Lust destroys common sense. They call it common sense. But when you are driven by lust, you lose your common sense. Immorality destroys common sense. You don't reason well again. You don't reason well again. When you see a young girl running after somebody who is old to be her grandfather, and all these things are product of association. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? The greatest sin that anybody has ever committed is with the people they associate themselves with. And it's still happening. He said, don't be unequally yoked with unbelievers. He said, what is the relationship between light and what? Darkness. Did you see that comparison? Light, darkness. Light and darkness never meet. Wherever you see darkness, you can't see the traces of light. Wherever you see light, you can never see the traces of darkness. That is how opposite they are. They don't meet. Light and darkness, they don't meet. Is it that you see darkness there dominating it, or like, but the two of them staying side by side? It has never happened, even in the natural. And let me tell you, you cannot stay in between light and darkness. Is it that you are in the darkness or you are in the light? And that is where many Christians are missing it. How can a Christian tell me that his best friend is an unbeliever? Then you are not a Christian. I'm telling you the truth. And that's what is common that we see. Your best friend is an unbeliever. You have one wife, your best friend has three. You say, Pastor, you see, we get along very well. We are best of friends. We've been friends since we were very young. All my childhood friends, as I speak to you today, I'm not talking to any one of them. I still see some of them in Akure here. I don't just greet them. I see some of them are lecturers in Fulta that we attended the Polytechnic together. They look at me and I look at them and everybody go there separately. I know what they are still doing. I know what they are still doing. In fact, they find it difficult to talk to me. The only ones that come close are the ones who come for prayer. You know, that one cannot invite me to a disco party, can they? That's what we are saying. It's me now that's bringing them to the church. But there are some of you here, you attend meetings organized by an unbeliever that you know. You are exposing yourself for attack. You know, we are talking about preservation. God will never preserve you where He didn't send you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He will never preserve you where He didn't send you, no matter how much you pray. You have His backing where your assignment is. You don't have His backing where He never sent you to go. That's what most pastors don't know. You have your territory. If you stay, the children of Israel were in Goshen and they were told to remain there. If they had gone outside Goshen, the spirit of death would have destroyed them. So, and the church of God is the New Testament Goshen. So you must stay within limit. Is somebody getting understanding? So when we are talking about preservation, it's not just prayer. We are going to pray. There's no doubt about that. It's not just taking the Holy Communion. We will take the Holy Communion. But you must stay within safe limit. You must associate yourself within safe limit. I don't honor every invitation. I'm telling you the truth. Don't honor every invitation if you want to. Because if you are not careful, some invitation will appear juicy. You must stay within safe limit. But another people, you see, there are times you must know when not to do something at all. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There are some things to stay within safe limit you have to avoid 100%. There are some people you give them a distance. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You'll be talking to them once in a while. Then there are some people you don't talk to them at all to be safe. In order for you to remain safe, because most of the problem you see that people are battling with are problems that association brought into their lives.
The message you just listened to is from the staples of God's Will Pentecostal Interdenominational Ministries. We hope you've been blessed richly. To get more messages such as this, connect with us on social media. God's Will Pentecostal Interdenominational Ministries on Facebook. God's Will Pentecostal Interdenominational on YouTube. We are located at No. 1 Total Deliverance Cathedral, Aule Bus Stop, off Elisha Garage, Akure, Odo State. Thank you for listening. God bless you.